Maranatha Christian Church is present in countries of every continent of the planet. Churches in countries of the three Americas, Europe, Africa, Asia, and Oceania, all connected by the same doctrine and the direction of the Holy Spirit of God, and united by the living Word. Our brothers and sisters in all parts of the world participate of the same service together, in the same body, in the same spirit. Through the transmission system, the members of Maranatha Christian Church around the planet are living a time of unity and fellowship, as the Hebrews lived at the time of their departure from Egypt, and the disciples of the Lord Jesus lived at the eve of his death on the cross at Calvary. People from all over the world have been reached by the eternal gospel and by the message that the Lord Jesus is coming soon.
I greet all with the peace of the Lord Jesus. We are starting yet another edition of Maranatha Christian Church's program announcing the eternal gospel. This program is made especially and with all affection for you and your whole family. I want to alert you to what the Bible says. There's a single project of God for your salvation. And to live this project, you need to make a choice. Have you thought about this already? The lessons today from Pastors Daniel Moreira and Sergio Souza explain the issue clearly and deepen your understanding about it. After, we will watch Dr. Maria talking about the importance of the accessibility work on a daily basis of the church. And in the perfect praise, the teacher Janinia will talk about various testimonies that were sent by families from all over Brazil. And in the class for the intermediate children adolescents, Professor Evelyn will speak about the Holy Spirit in Samson life. And now you'll watch the lessons from the money.
This is the segment, Lessons from the Mahanaim. God bless you all with the peace of the Lord. Pastor Sergio, peace of the Lord. Peace to the Lord, Pastor Daniel. Peace to the Lord to all. It is a great privilege for us to have you here. It's very important to us. And we have received many messages with testimonies and comments about the program announcing the everlasting gospel. You can also participate. On your screen right now, at the bottom of your screen, there's a QR code displayed. All you need to do is point your cell phone's camera to that QR code, and you will be directed to a WhatsApp phone number through which you will be able to send us a message. Participate in this. Send us your message. Share your testimony, your experience. The many messages that we received, we read them all, and they're very important to all of us. But because of our limited time, we can only mention a few of them. The first one comes from Salvador, state of Bahia, Brazil. Marcos Lazaro said, "The Lord speaks to me every time I watch the program. It has been a great blessing for the learning and contribution we send to the Sunday Bible school, together with the youth. The studies renew, edify, and strengthen us for the path." Amen. Pastor John Santos from Caucaia, Ceará State, Brazil, says, "The program Announcing the Everlasting Gospel has been a wonderful treasure that God manifested to His people. Glories to God." Amen. We left a question: what is your experience with the pleading for the blood of Jesus? And the answers, it would be very good if we had time to go over all of them, because we received many comments, many experiences that were shared with us. And one of them came from São Paulo, from Jeanette. And she says, "I was approached by armed robbers. The robbers were taking my car, but in my heart, I cried out for the blood of Jesus. Suddenly, the robbers came back to me, apologizing." Look how wonderful this is, Daniel. "They apologized and told me to go. They did not take anything. This was one of the many experiences I've had." Blessed be the name of the Lord. Paula Silva, she's from Miami, United States. "I am a nurse and I work in a hospital. And this pandemic period has been remarkable. God showed that every day of work, I should keep a constant pleading for the blood of Jesus, that I may be kept from contracting this virus. And so it has been." Luciano Rosa, he's a deacon in Niterói, Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. He says, "My wife and I were signed up for a seminar that would take place on a specific weekend. On Thursday night, that is, a little more than 24 hours from the seminar, our son, who requires special cares, had a respiratory crisis, which would keep us from attending that seminar at the Mahanaim. At that moment, we cried out for the blood of Jesus, for the healing of our son, and his condition improved immediately. He fell asleep and woke up feeling better with no issues." And they were even able to go to the seminar, so we see the healing, the preservation, for the preservation of the teaching and the learning of the word. Hannah Cardoso, she's a 10-year-old, an intermediate. We send a warm embrace to all of our intermediates, all of our adolescents. They're always participating in the program. She's from Teresina, Piauí, Brazil. She says, "Through the blood of Jesus, we can enter the Holy of Holies and have fellowship. Though I only came to the church in November of 2019, and shortly after we were hit with the pandemic, I was still able to have many experiences with the Lord, and I am very happy to be in this path that leads to heaven." Amen. Glories to Jesus. We thank everyone for their participation, everyone who sent us their comments. Today, our topic is men's choice. And we'll begin by reading the biblical text, which is in John chapter 3, verse 36, which says, "He who believes in the Son," he who believes in Jesus, that is, "has everlasting life. And he who does not believe the Son shall not see life, but the wrath of God abides on him." In this program, Dan Daniel and everyone who's watching us, we're going to show the plan or the project of God for the salvation of men. And the choice, this is very important, the choice that men must make. And we could even, Sergio, begin by presenting once again a chart showing how the process is done in men's life. salvation, the act, the process, the sovereignty of God. The text that this chart is based on is the text of 1 Peter chapter 1 verse 2, elect according to the foreknowledge of God the Father, in sanctification of the Spirit, for obedience and sprinkling of the blood of Jesus Christ. And as we see here on this chart, the gospel of Jesus has a message of salvation, but also of justice, or judgment rather. So here we see life and death. So this message of judgment and of grace is valid to all men. The grace of God. Grace is a gift of God. It is not an attribute of men. But grace, and this needs to be observed, grace does not consent in sin. Salvation is by grace. And the word says that it is by faith. Men are elect by God the Father in sanctification of the Spirit, the Holy Spirit, for a life of obedience and sprinkling of the blood of Jesus. That is, so this chart shows that from starting at the act that comes from God the Father, man accepts the calling of the Son Jesus, the calling for salvation. And there, the process begins. And what process is this? It is a spiritual life. It is the walk. And this process should be done in sanctification. Sanctification of the Holy Spirit. And as I said, salvation is given, beloved, by grace through faith. And faith is an agent that unites God and men. It is a seal. Once man receives the seal, he begins to have the right to live by faith and to have a life of intimacy with God. Today's theme, man's choice, is about a message from God. A special message of God to you, and you should be aware to this. And truly, you can even ask yourself or be questioning yourself, God has a question, God has a message for me? Yes, He does. He has a message for you yourself, who set aside this time to watch this program. And what a profound message and glorious message this is. That God has, and everyone should pay close attention to this message to make so they may make the best choice in the message of God. The message that God has for you at this moment is your soul is immortal. The soul will not die. The soul will never die. And truly, as the soul is separated from the body, it has two destinies. There are two potential destinies that it could face. Eternity with God or eternity without God. Therefore, beloved, there is no third destination, no third destiny, or no midterm for men. It's either eternity with God or eternity without God. As it's made very clear in the text that we read in the beginning, in John chapter 3 verse 36, exactly. He who believes in Jesus and walks on the path has eternal life, everlasting life, but he who does not believe will not see life. And we could even mention a few examples in the Bible of people who answered God's calling. Those who made the good choice to seek God's presence. And they accepted salvation. And we're going to begin with a man whose name was Zacchaeus, whose encounter with Jesus is described in Luke chapter 19, verse 5. What a glorious encounter. And we're going to see that it took place in the city of Jericho. So let us travel virtually now to Jericho. And we'll see here the Middle East. Here was Jericho. Jerusalem was right here. Jericho was on top a little bit. And this experience of Zacchaeus, and here we're seeing a photo of Jericho in our current days. But Zacchaeus' experience changed his life completely, completely transformed his life. He had salvation. He was rescued. He went to see Jesus because he was curious. He would see the ruins of Jericho. This is all in our days, in our times. But the ruins themselves, they were from Jesus' time. And the Lord Jesus went to Jericho many times, more than once. And here we see some pictures showing the ruins of Jericho. Amen. The Bible says that the Lord Jesus was walking through Jericho. Zacchaeus wanted to meet the man who was famous, very famous. Wherever Jesus walked through, a multitude surrounded him. Now, why did so many go to Jesus? Especially, they went to him for his word, for his doctrine, and obviously for the signs that he performed. And it's interesting, Sergio, that Zacchaeus went up, climbed the tree to see the Lord Jesus. But see what the word says in Luke chapter 19, verse 5. And when Jesus came to the place, Jesus looked up and saw him. He saw Zacchaeus and said to him, "Zacchaeus, make haste and come down, for today I must stay at your house." So the calling for salvation was made by Jesus. What a wonderful surprise for Zacchaeus. He wasn't expecting this. Jesus already knew he was there. Jesus called him. But it was up to Zacchaeus to make the choice to accept the calling, as we see in Luke chapter 19, verse 6. So he made haste, as the word says, and came down and received him joyfully. So Zacchaeus did not leave, did not make the decision some other day. He didn't question the calling of Jesus. In no way. Zacchaeus made haste. He ran to Jesus and received him joyfully. And the result of the choice that was made by Zacchaeus was salvation. The right to eternal life that he reached, as it's also mentioned in the word. We're going to see it in Luke chapter 19, verse 9. And the word says, "And Jesus said to him, 'Today salvation has come to this house, because he also is a son of Abraham.'" Another example, we could give many other examples, but another glorious example here of someone who heard the calling and answered the calling of God. We see that it's in chapter 4 in the Gospel of John that speaks about the experience of a nobleman from the king had with the Lord Jesus. This man lived in Capernaum, in the region of the Galilee, but he found out that Jesus was heading there to Cana. Cana was about 30 kilometers from Capernaum, and this man went there. He ran this distance. He traveled seeking Jesus because his son was ill. But before we show how this nobleman made the best choice, let's take a virtual trip to Cana of Galilee. If we even go through Capernaum here, let's get to know the area a little bit through the images. He lived here. He went all the way down to Cana. seeking to have an encounter with Jesus. This is just an aerial image. Here are a few ruins. And here's the image. This image is just showing a few images of the ruins of Capernaum from the time of Jesus. That man understood that Jesus can help me. Let us go to Cana now. These are current images. And over here we see the city of Cana back here. Some historians say that Jesus even walked here through this road, through this region. But anyhow, this is just for us to have a better idea of the region, get to know the region a little bit, so we can learn more about this experience. Because when he saw the Lord Jesus, the nobleman said, "My child dies." And he asked Jesus to go to his house to heal his son. The supplication, the cry of the nobleman to the Lord Jesus was very exact. As John chapter 4 verse 49 says, the nobleman said to him, "Sir, come down before my child dies." This was when he cried out, he made his request to the Lord Jesus. And Jesus said to that man, "Go your way, your son lives." That man did not question Sergio. That man did not argue. Neither did he doubt. As we see in John chapter 4 verse 50. Jesus said to him, "Go your way, your son lives." So the man, pay attention here. So the man believed the word that Jesus spoke to him. And he went his way. That is, he promptly believed the word of the Lord Jesus. And we could even ask, I ask you, Daniel, what were the effects, what were the results in the life of that man by his faith and by the choice he made? The effects, the results were his salvation and the salvation of his family and the healing for his son. He was on the way back to his home. And a few of his servants came to meet him and announced to him before he even arrived at his house, "Your son lives." And when he arrived at his house, he asked, "Listen, what was the hour that my son who was near dying, resurrected? What time was he healed? What time did he receive this blessing?" And the information they received us that the hour was the exact hour when Jesus said, "Your son lives." So that man and all of his home believed in the Lord Jesus. What a result. What a glorious effect in the life of those who make this best choice. If there is anyone in this world who can make a choice, who can choose where and which place your soul will live eternally, that person is you yourself. Differently than that which some people think. And this is very important to bring up, because some people could even say, and they even say actually, "Oh, the one who will choose where I will go, where my soul will go, is God." But the choice is not made by God. What the Bible teaches and affirms is that he who chooses the destiny of the soul is man himself. The choice belongs to man. And you who are watching us today, you can choose at this moment. You can choose now. You can either choose heaven and eternity with God, or you can choose that which is eternity without God. And this decision, Sergio, needs to be made now. Because when man delays, when man leaves it for another moment, he at that moment is already making his choice. He's choosing eternity without God. And this because if any of us die, and if we don't choose, if we choose eternity without God, that's where we will go. There's not going to be another opportunity. There's not going to be another chance once death arrives. And even if we don't die now, we're not here trying to scare anyone. We're only saying what the Bible shows very clearly, that even if you don't die now, you will be walking and living towards an eternity without God. But if you had not yet made your choice, if you had not yet made the choice to go to eternity, you can make that decision now. So that this choice may be made, we're going to look at 4 points that need to be understood and sought. The first point that we see, recognize that you are a sinner. This is in Romans chapter 3, verse 23. For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Everyone sinned. All have sinned. The second point, recognize that no one can enter heaven by their own efforts. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 8. For by grace you have been saved through faith, and that not of yourselves. It does not come of men. It is the gift of God. Amen. And next, recognize that only Jesus can take you to heaven. John chapter 4, verse 16. Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. No one. Only through Jesus. And the fourth point, accept Jesus as your only Savior. Acts chapter 16, verse 31. So they said, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and you will be saved, you and your household. And someone who perhaps is a bit younger, they can't even think to make that decision afterwards at a later time. But we need to emphasize, no one needs to be old to be close to eternity. And another detail that's very important, Sergio, besides death that can happen at any moment, the prophecies of the Bible confirm that Jesus will soon return. And the prophecies are fulfilled in our days. And for this reason, we have a question here. How will and how is your life when Jesus, for Jesus, is it ready for Jesus' return? Make a decision before God. The only way to reach eternity with God, according to the Bible, is through Jesus. He who does not choose heaven and who is walking towards eternity without God, he is under the wrath of God. So this is the appeal. Recognize that you're a sinner and accept the Lord Jesus as your only and sufficient Savior. Because it was the Lord Jesus himself who brought life from eternity. And he wants to take you there with him. Maranatha, the Lord Jesus will come. Amen. The segment Lessons from the Mahanai has its content produced from the seminars and the Sunday Bible School of the Maranatha Christian Church. The Sunday Bible School, which takes place every Sunday at 10 a.m. through our channel on YouTube. Continue to watch the program announcing the everlasting gospel with the segments that are to follow. then we're going to leave you with a question. And you can write it down. You can take a photo of it, or you can simply point your cell phone's camera to the QR code that is displayed on the bottom of your screen. And the question will be sent to you through WhatsApp. Here's the question. What happened to your life since accepting Jesus as your Savior? Once again, what happened to your life since accepting Jesus as your Savior? And the answers certainly will be testimonies. Participate. Send us your comment. In the sequence, we'll hear a song. And I would like to invite you, you who are watching us, youth, children, adults, participate in the song, sing along, because the praise moves the heart of God. In the praise, your heart will be blessed, your soul will be visited, and certainly there is a blessing through the song for your life and for your household. To all, the peace of the Lord Jesus, peace of the Lord.
Shaken by the storm.
Praise be the name of the Lord. What a blessing it is to live. The name of the Lord Jesus marks in our lives and in our hearts. From the moment we realize the biblical teaching that the church is the body of Christ, we understand that God's Holy Spirit is inclusive. That is, includes and makes everyone part of this body. And the importance of the accessibility work directed by the Holy Spirit for the day of the church, so that no one stays out of the body. You will learn more about this in the framework of the accessibility lesson with Dr. Maria.
Peace of the Lord. Our subject today is why we have an accessibility project in the church. Let's base ourselves on the text that is in Acts chapter 8, verse 31, that says, "How can I understand if someone doesn't teach me?" So, a deaf brother, he said this phrase that I think is very pertinent to all of the work around accessibility. And he said, "I don't see it as inclusion, because by the Spirit, we're included in the same body, but we need accessibility." Accessibility to what? What is our proposal? It's the accessibility to the Word of God. Is that our brothers who have a disability or who have a need for accessibility, they have the access to the teachings that are being practiced in the church and that are based on the Word of God. So we already have inclusion, because inclusion is introducing the individual to a group. In the church, everyone's a member of the body. So inclusion is something that by the Spirit is done in the church. Now, there are many members but one body. 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 20. Confirming that the body is unique. And within this body, we have several members. And accessibility, what is that all about? It's when you facilitate access. So, facilitate the access of our brethren in the church. Our work is also concerned with making accessibility attitudinal, which is to work with the church, with the people, so there's no prejudice, no stereotyping, stigma, and no discrimination of any kind in our behavior towards these people who have some need for accessibility. So we also have communicational accessibility that comes with Braille, auto description, and sign language, which makes communication accessible through these mechanisms of communication so that they have access to what is being taught. Similar to how in the world you have the hubs of accessibility, the Word of God also teaches us this. And in the Word, what are these hubs? What is the teaching of the Lord for us, for the church? In John 12:32, the Lord speaks about this. "And I," here is the Lord speaking, "when I am lifted up from the earth, all will be attracted to me." And this is confirmed by Peter in the book of Acts chapter 10, verses 34 and 35, when Peter says, "But then Peter opened his mouth and said, 'In truth, I perceive that God shows no partiality, but in every nation, whoever fears him and works righteousness is accepted by him.'" So the Lord does not demonstrate any partiality. And this is what he teaches us, what he teaches his church, that we should have a welcoming environment, an environment of real acceptance of all the differences. Each human being is unique. We all have our singularities. And our brothers with that have any degree of disability or who are in need of some sensitivity or accessibility, they have these specificities, and all of us together are one body. And the Holy Spirit is the one who helps us. He guides all things. And in our work, because we're human, we fail. But the Holy Spirit is perfect, and it compensates us for our flaws and teaches us the real way of what the Lord wants for the church. So the purpose of this accessibility work, our concern, is providing accessibility, making education accessible. Offer these brothers and sisters the same opportunity to learn the word of the Lord. And with that, we're promoting salvation, because by hearing the word comes our salvation. So that's the goal of the work of accessibility of the Maranatha Christian Church. Peace of the Lord Jesus.
And Professor Janine is back, and I'm sure you missed her. And to start the work of the year in 2021, today we'll see several testimonies sent and prepare ourselves for the practical classes that will start next week. Let us watch.
Peace the Lord to all, especially to our children, intermediates, and adolescents. We will begin our segment today telling the experience of Beatrice. She's 6 years old. She's from Governador Valadares. Her parents noticed from the beginning of this work that she might have a absolute ear, because she's been able to play every single one of the songs. And her greatest focus is to evangelize her older sister, who is an adult. She's been sending a lot of videos to her, and she's already seeing the results from this. Her sister's already participating in services and has been receiving a blessing. Let's watch. What a blessing. Now, let's watch our little ones that are developing and happy to participate in this. Rafaela Amiel, she's 3 years old, from Madrid, Spain. Inácio do Vale Barros, he's 11 months old, from Queimados, Rio de Janeiro.
Melissa tem 2 anos, de Contagem, Minas Gerais.
Melissa is 2 years old, and she's from Contagem, Minas Gerais.
Ana tem 3 anos, Salvador, Bahia.
Ana is 3 years old, and she's from Salvador, Bahia.
Jesus.
Praise the Lord. Did you know that while you do the videos, your siblings, your cousins, all the classes, they're closer to each other? It's a great moment to share. The older is helping the younger, respecting each other, and they are being fortified. Praise the Lord. Let's continue watching the participation.
Buenos Aires, Argentina.
Benjamin, Brenda, and Nicalia from Buenos Aires, Argentina.
Benjamin de São Gonçalo, Rio de Janeiro.
Miguel and Benjamin are from São Gonçalo, Rio de Janeiro.
Os irmãos Samuel e Sara de Ibirité, Minas Gerais.
The siblings Samuel and Sarah from Ibirité, Minas Gerais. Samuel, Ana Luisa, and Sabrina from Ipatinga, Minas Gerais.
Rebecca de Altamira, Pará.
Rebecca from Altamira, Pará. Rafaela and Paola from Brasília, Distrito Federal.
Muito bom. Agora vou fazer
very um good. Now I want to invite the whole family to participate in our next class. Everybody is on vacation. And we will make a drum from recycled materials, materials that we have at home. So you are going to be able to use it or give it to a younger brother, cousin, or friend. Let's look at the materials. We're going to need a can or an empty container, aluminum foil, paper towel, or any paper, a piece of paper, a skewer, or a long color pencil, string or a rubber band, latex balloons, colorful tape, and the safety scissors.
Vamos deixar tudo separadinho, amém?
Até let's have that all prepared, okay? Till the next bus, peace of the Lord to all.
Nós estamos estudando sobre o poder de Deus na vida
de Samson. We are learning about the power of the Lord in the life of Samson. And the class today is about the wedding of Samson. So let's read the text. So he said to them, out of the eater came something to eat, and out of the strong came something sweet. Now for 3 days they could not explain the riddle. Samson, he went to the city of the Philistines and he met a young woman and he wanted to marry her. So he told his parents to go there to meet his bride. And as they were going, a big lion came towards them, and the power of the Holy Spirit came upon Samson's life. And Samson, he hurt and killed that lion, and he did not tell that secret to anybody. As a few days went by, it was the day of the wedding. So they went back to the city of the Philistines, and on their way there, he said, I'm going to see what happened to that lion that I killed. And when he got there, he only found the bones, and there was a beehive, and there they produced honey. And Samson, he ate from that honey and gave it to his parents as well. And Samson still didn't say anything to anybody about where that honey came from. So on the day of the wedding, Samson told a riddle to those who that were there in the party. And he said, I will tell you a riddle, and those who find out what it means, I will give a reward. And it said, out of the eater came something to eat, and out of the strong came something sweet. But nobody knew what that secret meant. And the bride started to get sad and started to cry and asked him to tell the secret. And a day went by, 2 days, 3 days. And on the seventh day, Samson revealed the secret. And he said, what's more sweet than honey? And what's stronger than a lion? This story points to the wedding of the Lord Jesus with his faithful church. What is stronger than the lion? Who is the lion? Jesus, he is the lion, the tribe of Judah, the one who died to give us eternal life, to give us salvation. And on the third day, he resurrected. He did not stay dead. He resurrected. And what's sweeter than honey? Honey speaks of what? The sweetness of salvation. What a wonderful thing. We will not be lost in this world. We will go with the Lord Jesus to eternity. And honey, the honey only came after the lion was dead. Jesus needed to die in order to reveal this great salvation to you and to me as well. The seventh day represents the day of the wedding. The wedding, the great day of the Lord. The day that the Lord will take and rapture all his church, and together we will be with Jesus in eternity. The Holy Spirit that came upon the life of Samson wants to enter your life and my life. The Lord has power to visit our hearts, to give us joy, and give the sweet honey of salvation.
Each edition of the program announcing the eternal gospel, we are filled with joy with the participation and messages sent from people from all over Brazil and also abroad. This makes your audience very happy, and your participation is important to us. Interact with us. Point your mobile phone camera to this QR code on this screen and talk about the different lessons through this program and what experiences you have had with this program, and also your suggestions. It'll be a great joy to hear from you. And now, I want to talk to you, who is touched by the message transmitted through this program. You who want to know God and not only live a religious experience, but a true experience with the Lord and hear his voice. We have a direct channel that will assist you. Call this number anytime during the day or night. The number is 0800-707-3076. This is an exclusive number to serve those who are not yet members of Maranatha Christian Church, who need a word from the Lord and even a prayer. And you can also follow us on Instagram and Facebook, and access the church's website and Radio Money by downloading the apps freely and browse through them and learn more about us and our digital platforms. And you can still also follow our weekly schedule published every week, every Monday, on our social networks, on the Radio Money app. You can hear praises 24 hours a day and can watch podcast messages. And now we are coming to the end of this edition of Maranatha Christian Church's Announcing the Eternal Gospel. And do not forget, every Sunday during 10 a.m. in the morning on Maranatha Christian Church's YouTube channel, you can watch our Sunday Bible School, and it's something that you do not want to miss. And next week, if God allows, we will be together once again during this time for one more edition of Maranatha Christian Church's Announcing the Eternal Gospel. Maranatha, the Lord Jesus comes.